For another day, we thank you for your love and your mercies. We thank you, God, for what you've been doing in our lives, Lord God. Father, as we're about to go into the message this morning, Lord, I pray, oh God, that you will lead, Lord God. I pray, oh God, that Father God, that everything that you come forth, Lord God, everything that should be said this morning, Lord God, it will be done according to your will and your way, Lord God. It will come directly from you, Lord God. I pray, oh God, that your people this morning will be attentive to your word, Lord God, and Father God, they will, Lord God, Father God, to help them to grow deeper, Father, in you, Lord God. Have your way this morning. We give you honor, we give you glory, and we give you praise as we look to you. We say thanks.
Hallelujah. Amen and amen. Bless the name of the Lord. Choose your battles. Hallelujah. And this morning, the passage that I want to read this morning is taken from Numbers 14, and we're going to read from verse 40 through 45. Numbers 14, verse 40 through 45. And it reads, it said, early the next morning, they set out for the highest point in the hill country, saying, now we are ready to go up to the land the Lord promised. Surely we have sinned. But Moses said, why are you disobeying the Lord's command? This will not succeed. He said, do not go up because the Lord is not with you. You will be defeated by your enemies. He said, 43 said, for the Amalekites and the Canaanites will face you there because you have turned away from the Lord. He will not be with you and you will fall by the sword. 44, nevertheless, in their presumption, they went up towards the highest point in the hill country. Though neither Moses nor the ark of the Lord moved from the camp. 45, then the Amalekites and the Canaanites who lived in that hill country came down and attacked them and beat them down all the way to Horma. Bless the name of the Lord. You know, many of us have heard this statement, choose your battle wisely. Or you may have heard, every battle is not worth fighting. Pick your battles. Don't sweat the small stuff. You've heard that at one point or another. All of these statements, you're basically saying the same thing, and this is very important. I believe this is very important advice. It's a very important piece of advice. It is not good to be involved in every fight. It's not good to be involved in every fight. Some fights, they're not worth fighting. And so as a child of God, we have to choose our battle. We have to know when to let go and let God have his way. Choosing your battle is a very important skill, and it's often crucial to your Christian life. It's crucial to your Christian life. So what does it mean to choose your battle? What does it mean to choose your battle? To choose your battle is to choose not to participate in minor, unimportant, or overly difficult arguments, contests, or confrontation. What you want to do is to save your strength instead for those that will be of greater importance, or where one has a greater chance of success. As a father, as a husband, I have to choose my battle. I can't argue over every little thing. It will cause issues, it will cause problems in the relationship. And the same is true for parents. Pick your battles with your kids so you don't run yourself ragged.
You have to learn to choose your battles. The best politicians were in a political time. And look around, the best politicians, they pick their battles wisely. If they become too embroiled in petty debates, they will never get anything done. They will never get anything done. Let me tell you today, as long as you are a child of God, as long as you are alive, you will have battles. Battles will come your way. The enemy, he will always put something in your way in order to get you, on track. He will put some form of battles in your path. He's going to put battles in your way. I like the quote that C. Joy Bell, C, don't know who that is, but I was just reading and I saw this quote. I like this quote from where it states, choose your battles wisely. That after all, life isn't measured by how many times you stood up to fight. He said, it's not winning battles that make you happy, but it's how many times you turn away and choose to look into a better direction. So life is too short to spend it on warring. Fight only the most important to rescue. You cannot fight every battle and expect to come out victorious. Can't fight every battle and expect to come out victorious on every side. As human beings, we often fall into the trap of fighting for every issue, standing for every issue, and arguing for every issue. But the truth that I have learned as I study God's word is that we need to fight battles that only God allows us to fight. Some battles, you just need to walk away. Forget it. Don't argue. Don't push back. Just leave it in the hands of the Lord. Let him fight for you. Yes, understand. I want you to understand that the Lord, he has never lost a battle. And one thing, I'm sure, he is always ready. Always ready. He's always ready. So don't sweat the small stuff. Don't fight over everything. Don't argue over everything. Sometimes you just need to just walk away. Just listen, Lord, you just see what I'm going through. You see the problem that I'm faced with. You see, Lord God, the issue on hand. And today, Lord, I just want to leave it in your hands. I'm not going to fight. I'm going to leave it in your hands. Just rest it in his hands. Let him take care of it. He has never lost a battle. He is always ready. Leave it in his hands. At times you may have someone approach you for an advice in a particular matter. And while you're listening to the individual, is your relative, you go against what the Holy Spirit or what the Lord is saying to you, and you provide them with advice, and realizing that what you are doing can ruin them. Allow the Lord to work. Allow the Lord to work. If he tells you to leave the battle in his hands, leave it there. And don't worry about it. Leave it in his hands. The battle is the Lord's. The battle is the Lord's. Songwriter said, leave it there. Why don't you leave it there? Take your burden, take your battles, take them to the Lord and leave it there. Leave it in his hands. He will take care of it. in the passage that we read in Numbers 14, verse 40 through 45, the Lord had promised the children of Israel a land for themselves. And so Moses, what he did was select 12 men to scout out the land. Select 12 men to scout out the land and to bring back information as to what they saw. And 10 of those men came back with a bad report. 10 of them came back with a bad report. They showed no faith in God. Remember, if you remember, the Lord had brought the children of Israel out of Egypt. Egypt had the strongest army at the time. They were the world power. They had the most powerful army. And God, he brought the children of slavery out of Egypt. And here he was promising them a land that they were doubting. 10 of the men came back. And then so the 10 who came back with nothing positive to say this, what they started to do was to spread doom and gloom across the camp. And you know rumors, it can catch on quickly. The message of doom and gloom, it catches on quickly. Look around you. Look at some of the papers that are written today. Once they're talking about something negative, it catches on. Anything positive? No. Only a few people look at it. But once it's something negative, once it's spreading doom and gloom, it catches on like wildfire. And so they hear the 10 men, they return, and they start to spread doom and gloom messages across the camp. And it catches on quickly because the children of Israel, they started to believe that God could not help them. They started to believe that the God who brought them out of Egypt, who took them across the Red Sea, who put fire before them, at night, who put the cloud to shield them by day. Here they started to believe that he could not give them the land that he promised. And so because of their unbelief, because of their disobedience and their unfaithfulness, the Lord gave them exactly what they were worrying about. He told them that they were going to spend 40 years in the wilderness until their generation. And once Moses, he read God's sentence to the children of Israel, the people, they presumptuously proceeded to go up what's going to happen. No, they wanted to go up and take the land on their own. Their response, it was typical of those who get caught doing wrong and are suddenly repentant. And so wanting to turn everything around. Wanting everything to go back to the way it was before the judgment fell. Here, they went up on their own. They went up to fight a battle on their own, trying to carry on with life as if nothing had happened. The Israelites, they refused to accept God's discipline, as they had refused to accept his promise. And so they rebelled against him again, even though Moses sounded the ominous warning. They rebelled. The Lord will not be with you. Numbers 14, verse 43. They tried to gain his blessing without him, which is unbelief. And so God allowed their enemies to defeat them. God allowed their enemies to defeat them. The key to their success did not lie in their military might or their psychological power, but their obedience and trust in God. The key to your success in your battle does not lie in your strength, in your ability, in your psychological power, but it lies in your obedience and your faith in God. And the Lord tells you, then do not fight. I want you to understand today, just as you can't be defeated with the Lord on your side, you can't be victorious without Him. I wonder if you're here with this morning. If the Lord tells you that the battle is His, leave it in His hands. If He tells you not to fight, why are you going to fight? Why? The Lord, if He's fighting the battle for you, why are you going to take it on yourself? He never lost the battle. He's always victorious. He's always ready. He's always on time. Leave it in His hand. Just as you can't be defeated with the Lord on your side, you can't be victorious without Him. You cannot be victorious without Him. Many battles are not worth our energies. Many battles are not worth our energy. When you go to battle, be sure that the victory will be worth the price. When you go fight, be sure that the victory will be worth the price. Be sure that the Lord is there with you. You don't want to end up like the children of Israel. You don't want to go up to fight and the Lord is not there. Choose your battle this morning. If the Lord tells you to fight, then you fight with all your might. If He tells you not to fight, don't fight. You may ask, why do I need to choose my battles? Why? One, because battles take energy. It takes energy. When you fight a battle, you are going to expend energy. You're going to use up some energy. You will become tired. And if the battle you choose to fight is not important, what you're doing is putting yourself in a precarious position. You're putting yourself at risk because battles always our way. As Christians, as a child of God, battles, they're gonna come your way. But you have to know which one to fight. You cannot fight every battle. If the Lord is not in the battle, you are fighting in vain. You will become tired. You will get weary. And when the right battle comes along that you should fight, you will not have the energy to fight. Not everything that somebody say about you, you should respond. It's not every time they look at you a particular way, you should respond. Choose your battles. Choose your battles. Battles take energy. And if you try to fight every battle, you have a lot of energy. You are going to get tired. You are going to get weary. Second point that I want to bring across is that battles they take time. Battles take time. You look around you, there's a lot of wars going on. Ukraine and Russia, they've been fighting for a long time. Battles take time. Every problem you wrap yourself in takes. Every problem takes time and energy. And so when you spend your time fighting meaningless battle, it is not good. Your time could be better spent doing better things, praying, studying the word, getting yourself equipped. When you're fighting frivolous battle, you're expending energy. You're using up our valuable time. So do not waste your time, my brothers and sisters, fighting frivolous battles. Victory isn't all that matters. Sometimes making the best use of your time is better. In Acts chapter 6, verse 2 to 4, the Bible teaches us that it is not wise to be involved in everything that is going on around us. I wonder if you hear me this morning. It is not good to be involved in everything that is going on around us, but we should select cautiously so that we can remain calm and steadfast in life. That's the word. Third point is that battles takes resources. Battles takes resources. When you go into battle, you usually need some form of resource to sustain you throughout the fight. You hear me this morning? So when you go into battle, you need resources to sustain you throughout the fight. Again, I can go back to some of the wars that are going on, some of the battles that are being fought right now. Ukraine, Russia, Israel, Palestine. Battles take resources. You've heard on the news the amount of resource the United States is providing both Ukraine and Israel. They provide a lot of resource to aid in the battles. Battles take resources. They spend billions on those battles. It takes resources. And so the battle that you fight, though it might seem minuscule, it might seem small to you, it takes resources. It might drain you emotionally. It might drain you physically. It might drain you mentally. It takes resources. Those battles that you choose to fight, it could cost you financially. You have to choose your battles. Again, if allow the Lord for you. Don't get involved in every and anything. Allow him to take the lead. Rest it in his hands. It's been proven over and over and over again that he has never lost. If you want to be victorious, rest it in his hands. Bless the name of the Lord. No matter the situation, no matter what you're being faced with, no matter what the battle is, leave it in his hands. If he didn't tell you to fight, don't fight. Bless the name of the Lord. Take it to him and leave it there. Not all battles are important. Not all battles are important. Some things simply don't matter in the long run. Some things don't matter in the long run. If you think about what matters 5, 10, 15, 20 years from now, it's apparent that many of the things we worry about are small, and we should instead just focus on the big and important things. Some battles are not important. Leave it in the hands of the Lord. You should sit down and maybe just look back on your life. You might be would be maybe laughing, or you might be saying to yourself, what was I thinking? That issue that came up 10 years ago, I spent 2 years, 3 years worrying, fighting that issue. And looking back now, it was stupid. Made no sense. Some battles are not important. It's not worth your energy. It's not worth your time. It's not worth your finances. It's not worth it. Not important. Choose your battles. Bless the name of the Lord. You may ask, how do I pick my battles? So the goal in picking battles is to choose the issues which, according to the Bible, have the most significance. The battle you choose should be aligned with the word of God. Remember, if God is not in it, you are sure to lose that battle. God is not in it, you're sure to lose that battle. So take time to pray about the issue. Take time to pray about the issue. What issues seriously undermine the faith? A lot of faith, a lot of time. When there is an issue, you don't have to make a decision immediately. I found that many take time to pray about the issue. Take time to pray about the issue. You don't, sometimes you don't need to make a decision immediately. The Lord just dropped in my mind. You know, sometimes you have these salespeople who come around, they come to your home and they make a pitch. And some of us, because, we make a decision on the spot, we get ourselves in trouble because, yeah, we make the decision and then we are sitting down. Oh my God, who am I going to pay for it? It's not worth it. You don't have to make a decision immediately. Take time to pray about the issue. There is a problem in your relationship. Take it to the Lord in prayer. In Isaiah 42, 13, the Bible states, the Lord goes out like a mighty man, like a man of war. He stirs up his zeal. He cries out. He shouts aloud. He shows himself mighty against his foe. In Isaiah 43 and verse 2, he said that when you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. Allow the Lord to fight for you. You want to grow in your relationship? You want to be better on the job? You want to be a better parent? Choose your battles. Allow God to fight for you. Allow the Lord to fight for you. One thing I want realize that not every battle, not every situation deserves your anger or even your full attention. Next point that I want to bring across is put the problem or the issue into context. The only right place to start this discussion is with the Bible. The Word of God is the source of our faith. It provides us with revelation on God's character. The Bible reveals Jesus Christ. And so when you're faced with a problem, check to see if the response you're undertaking, check to see if it aligns with the Word of God. Ask yourself, is this battle worth it? Is this battle worth it? Remember, as a child of God, you are representing Jesus. You are representing the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And so whatever you do, it should align with the character of our King. Some issue just require a soft answer. The Bible says a soft answer turns away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger. Grievous words stir up anger. Soft answer turns away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger. Sometimes that's all you need to do is to just give a soft answer. It's the Bible, not me. Just give a soft answer. And of course, it's not as if God needs our help in keeping his reputation clean. But rather, it is that Christians, we are to represent him accurately and faithfully. We are to represent him accurately and faithfully. Bless the name of the Lord. You know, as Christians, if you don't follow the Bible's teaching on lifestyle choices, and behavior, in a sense, you're degrading the world's opinion of God. And this happens when so-called Christians are aggressive, stingy, sectarian, denominational, when they're rude, when you're materialistic, when you're arrogant. Third point, what issues have the most harmful effect on people? How to pick your battles? You have to look, bless the name of the Lord, at what issues have the most harmful effect on people. The issues worth fighting about are the issues which have to do with the life or with lives, both present and eternal, of people. You have to consider those issues which affect the largest number of people. Some issues affect the lives of millions of people, even if those people are unborn. Example, abortion, other enslaved today, other issues have to do with the proclamation of the gospel to people who have never heard. I've never heard it. What issues have eternal consequences? Because this present life is not all there is. The Bible tells us that there is an eternal destiny for every single individual. And so choose to fight over the issues that have an impact upon eternity. Don't stress the small stuff. Don't get angry and sin over stupid stuff. Choose to fight over the issues that have an impact upon eternity. Hope you hear me this morning. Choose to fight over issues that have an impact upon eternity. Do not sweat the small stuff. It's not every single thing that people say about you you're gonna get angry over, get upset over, sin over. Don't sweat the small stuff. Choose your battles this morning. Choose your battles. Ephesians 6, the verse 10 it said, makes it very clear that, well, we don't wrestle against flesh and blood, against the authorities, against cosmic powers over the present darkness, against spiritual foes of evil in heavenly places. Choose your battles. Choose your battles. So you may ask, so how do I fight? Because when we talk about battles, some may think of combat, war. You know, how do I fight? Think of killing people, blowing up things when you talk about battles. But again, Ephesians tells us that we don't wrestle against flesh and blood, but we wrestle against but against rulers, against the authorities, against cosmic powers over this present darkness, against spiritual forces of evil in heavenly places. So how do we fight? And I think there are three ways that we can look at. One, and I'm winding down. One, we should pray. Pray. Prayer is upheld as a central feature of the Christian weaponry. When we think of warfare in terms of prayer, as Ephesians 6:10 said, makes complete sense. Prayer also takes a lot of pressure off you. Hope you hear me this morning. Prayer takes a lot of pressure off you. It's not about how much you pick it, how many anti whatever. Alert and persevere, but ultimately it's about what God does, not what you or I do. It's about what God does. So the first thing that we need to do is to pray. Second thing, I said I'm winding down, I'm coming down, is to share the word. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 24 teaches that that the pastor must not be quarrelsome, but instead should be able to teach. This is an important contrast. It suggests that the way to be combative is not to be in a quarrelsome manner, but with sound words. 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 13. If you notice in this passage in 2 Timothy, we read that such teaching will lead to correcting his opponents. God's leading God's leading to knowledge of the truth, and that they may come to their senses. The teaching, correcting knowledge, truth, and come to their senses, verbiage, are a pretty clear indication that teaching takes a central role in the defense of the truth. So such teaching is not the red in the face kind of rant that we discuss, but I talk about above. What a patient explanation of the truth as revealed in God's word. A verbal declaration of the Bible is of paramount importance. Choose your battles. Pray. You fight by praying. You fight by staying in the word. And the last point, you fight by living. Live. A Christian fight by living. A Christian fight by living. Living, don't underestimate. Don't underestimate the power of a Christ-like lifestyle. The way that Christians defend truth and combat error is by living out their spirit-empowered, grace-filled, gospel change life. You fight by living. Sometimes you don't have to say anything at work when it gets rough and tough. Sometimes you don't have to say anything. Choose your battles this morning. Live your life so that others would see Christ through you. Don't sweat the small stuff. Don't get emotional over every little thing. Trust God. Lean on Him. Leave it in His hand. The battle is not yours, it's His. Allow Him to fight for you unless He tells you to fight. Allow Him to fight. When He fights, you are going to win. You are going to be victorious. If He's in it, you are a winner. If He's not in it, you're not going to be victorious. Trust Him this morning. Lean on Him. Bless the name of the Lord. Leave it in His hands. Pray, study the word, live according to His will and His way, and you will be victorious. The battle, my brothers and sisters, it's not yours. It is the Lord's. Trust Him this morning. Exercise your faith in Him. Hallelujah. It's not yours. It is His. It's His. It is His. Hallelujah. The battle is not yours. So as you go about this week, you're going to be faced with different issues, with different situations. The enemy, he's going to bring all type of things against you. He's going to bring everything up for you to fight. Situation deserves your anger or even your full attention.
When you're growing, as you grow in Christ, you will realize that not every situation deserves your anger. Don't get angry over everything. Don't get angry over everything. Not everybody is worth your energy, your time, your emotion. Not everybody is worth it. Trust God. Put your faith in Him. Leave it in His hands. And let Him do the rest. I pray this morning that this word was a blessing to you. And after today, you will choose your battles better. You will know what to fight because you're going to listen to the Lord. And when He said back up, you're going to back up. If He said go forward and fight, then you fight. And fight with everything in you. But when He said stop, you stop. And I can guarantee you that you will be victorious. Don't take on no battle like the children of Israel did, that He hasn't sanctioned. If He didn't sanction it, that means you're not supposed to be in it. Trust Him on it. And allow Him to fight your battle. Bless the name of the Lord. Let us pray. Father, we give You glory this morning. We honor You. And we worship You, Lord. Father, You are our King of Kings and our Lord of Lords. Father, as I come to You this morning, I pray, Father, for those who are listening in this morning, who have listened to Your word, Lord God. I pray this morning, Lord God, that, Father God, that, Father, that You will help them, Lord God, that after today, Lord God, they will know how to better choose their battles. Father God, they will, Father God, listen more keenly to You, Lord God. I pray this morning, Lord God, that after today, Lord God, they will exercise their faith, Father, in You, Lord God. I pray this morning, Lord God, that after today, they will not, Father, do like the children of Israel did, Lord God, when the men returned and started spreading the rumor, started spreading the doom and the gloom across the camp, Lord God. They listened to that, Lord God, instead of trusting You, instead of leaning on You, Lord God, instead of, Lord God, Father God, leaning on Your promises, Lord God, instead of looking back at what You have done and realizing, Lord God, that what lies ahead is not even as great as what You had done in the past. Help them not, Lord God, to seek the battles on their own, Lord God, but to rest it in Your hands, Lord God, to trust You, Lord God, because You're always ready. You're always on time, Lord God. And any battle You are involved in, Lord God, You will come out victorious. You will be victorious. I pray this morning, Lord God, that, Father God, it doesn't matter the situation that your children are faced with this morning, whether it's relational, Lord God, oh God, whether, Lord God, it's a financial battle, whether it's an emotional battle, whatever the battle is this morning, I pray, oh God, that morning, Lord God, because You are more than able, Father God. You, Lord God, Father God, are victorious in every battle, Lord God. And so I pray, Lord God, that You will help us, Father, to rest everything in Your hands. Cast it, Lord God, upon You, Lord God, because You care for us. I pray this morning, Lord God, that You will help us, Lord God, that we'll seek You first. We'll get down on our knees, Lord God, when the battle of life rages, Lord God. I pray, oh God, that we'll get on our knees. We'll get in the Word, Lord God. We will live according to Your will and Your way, Lord God, because we know, Lord God, that by doing that, Lord God,
you. We magnify you. We lift you up because you are our King of Kings and you are our Lord of Lords. Have your way in our lives, Lord God. Choose our battles, Lord God. Tell us when to go forward. Tell us when to fight, Lord God. Tell us when to withdraw, Lord God. Father, this morning, have your way, Father. Have your way, God. Cover your people. Strengthen them. Keep them, Lord God. Father, for those who were expending their energy on frivolous things, Lord God, and now they're feeling weary, weak, sad, Lord God, I pray, oh Lord God, that you would just pull them back in, Lord God, to the place where you want them to be, Lord God. I pray this morning that you, Lord God, will restore this morning to them the joy of your salvation. I pray this morning, Lord God, that you will re-energize such an individual, Lord God. I pray, oh God, that Father, Lord God, that you will help them, Father God, that you will renew their mind, Lord, this morning. Help them to realize that not every battle is worth fighting. And the frivolous battle that they were spending their energy on, it makes no sense, Lord God. Pull them back, Lord God. Re-energize them. Bring them back to a place, Father God, in you, where they can have the feel your joy, your peace, your love this morning. Strengthen your people, Lord God. As we go through this week, I pray, oh God, that you will go with us. You will fight for us, Lord God. You will help us to be victorious, Lord, in every battle because we rested on you, Lord God. Have your way this morning. Take charge, Lord. As we look to you, we say thanks. In your mighty and your holy name, I pray. Leave it in his hands. It's the name of the Lord. Whatever he said, just do it. And you will be victorious. God bless you all this morning.